Hey, what is up, guys? It's Arodiad here. Welcome to our Pokemon Leaf Green Wedlocke series, episode 28. And in the last episode, we had an extremely close call against Bruno with Kurama. But Kurama was able to get that, I'm pretty sure, 10% burn or something, 20, 30, I don't care. But got the burn on the Machamp and did take it out. So, we're going to be taking on Agatha. Probably one of the most scariest ones as well, since we don't have anything really super effective. We have Coin's Bite. However, Coin, I don't even know if you're actually a physical or a special attacker, come to think of it. You are more special attacker, so I guess that's good, but it is not stab. Slash will not affect it, so why don't we go up to Agatha and see if we can do some damage with our Persian, because Persian isn't really used that often. I really do like Persian, but we have Agatha. Agatha, how are you going? I am Agatha of the Elite Four. Your voice is terrible. I hear Oak's taken a lot of interest in you, child. That's not weird at all. That old duff was once tough and handsome. Hey, don't call Mr. Professor Oak unhandsome, alright? He's amazing. But that was decades ago. He's a shadow. I was about to say shadow. He is a shadow of his former self. Now, he just wants to fiddle with his Pokedex. He's wrong. Pokemon are for battling. Nick, I'll show you how a real trainer battles. Okay, I'm really scared. Agatha, how are you going, Agatha? Ooh, Agatha, please show mercy. I know you have those Gengars and those Haunters and everything like that, but ooh, it's still very scary. So he leads off with Gengar level 54. I don't know if, I'm pretty sure I'll be able to outspeed. Yeah, Coin goes to Bite. I cannot go for Fake Out on this guy. Please just take it out. No, it does not, but please go for Flinch. No, it does not. Double Team. Okay, this can get extremely annoying. Pretty much with double team, if you don't hit the first double team, they're going to go for more double teams and it's just going to screw you up. So, please hit the bite coin. Yes, there you go, coin. There you go. Seeing the damage that did makes me wonder if we're going to be able to two-hit kill the Gengar that's coming in, which really does scare me. But here is the Golbat. We're going to switch out into our Spark Plug for the simple reason that Spark Plug is super effective against Golbat. I think it's the only thing that is super effective against. We might need to use some of the thunders against some of these Pokemon, but we do have 6 of those thunders left, so let's go for Shockwave. Hopefully that will take it out. I'm pretty sure it will. It's a Golbat, level 54. Look at it with his big cheesy smile. Just swallowing that. Can you swallow it and hold it though? That's the question. No, you cannot. Shockwave will take it out. My go-to plan is probably to go into Persian for the Arbok. No, actually, it's got Intimidate, doesn't it? So we're going to stay in because we are special attackers. Or at least I'm pretty sure it gets Intimidate. It gets Intimidate, but I don't know if it's primary. Yeah, I don't know if it was its primary ability. But we're going to be going for the... No, doesn't it get Shed Skin? No, it has Intimidate. What am I talking about? Should I go for the Thunder Wave? Actually, Thunder Wave would be good to have on other against other Pokemon. But we went for the Thunder. It missed Screech. Our defense is lowered. That isn't good. Defense harshly fell. Let's go for a Thunder Wave because that means that we can cripple this Arbok and hopefully get full paralysis. That is a hopefully, actually. Please, Screech. Okay, we're at -4 defense. I don't know if this guy has any physical moves. Actually, I'm kind of thinking that he does not because I don't know. Sludge Bomb is special in this, isn't it? Let's go for Pokemon, however. And no, Sludge Bomb is physical in this. Ooh, let's go into Coin. And that way we can get some little fake out damage and just try to take this guy out. Because I do want to have Sludge Bomb. Told you we got Sludge Bomb. Please do less than half. It did less than half, but we got poisoned. So what I'm going to do is going to be using a full restore and hoping for that chance of paralysis on that Arbok. Pretty much, let's go for the healing on Coin and really hope that works. Sludge Bomb. Okay, take this guy out. No, take it. What am I saying? I thought I was attacking. Okay, let's go for a Slash. Why don't I go for a fake out then? Please don't take coin out. Please don't. Ooh, Coin, survive the poison. Survive the poison. Please. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. That was scary. That is extremely scary. Okay. This is scary. Iron Tail missed. Okay. I'm scared. Should I go for bites and hope for flinches or slash and hope for crits? I'm thinking slashes is a better option. Did not crit, but Sludge Bomb, we'll be able to tank one of those, even if it is a crit. As long as it's not a crit and poison, then we are stuffed. But it is at least, we couldn't have one without the other. So, Coin, I know you've been getting poisoned like crazy, but let's go for another slash. Should be able to take this Arbok out. I'm pretty sure that Coin is going to be taking a backseat for every other Pokemon in this battle. Even though there is another I'm pretty sure there's a Haunter and a Gengar. So why don't we switch out into Spark Plug? I'm going to go for the Thunder Wave just to cripple this guy even more and see if he would be able to... doesn't this one carry like Hypnosis and everything like that? Well, it'd be good to have a status on this guy. Please don't carry like something stupid like Curse or something. But it paralyzed. I'm actually going to use this turn to go for a full restore. And that way I can go into coin. And just in case we do need to use coin later on, we have that option to use coin. So, Hypnosis does hit. I'm not that stressed about that for the simple reason that we do have Awakenings. Not only that, Gengar is paralyzed, which was the main thing that we set out to do. Let's go into here. Do we have the Awakenings up here? We do have Awakenings up here. Let's use it on Spark Plug. That is extremely good. That is extremely good. Sludge Bomb. I know your special attack is crazy, but I'm pretty sure Sludge Bomb is a physical move in this, so it shouldn't do that much. But we get the... What? Okay, I don't know why there is being so many poisons this. We're going to be using all our full restores just on this battle alone. But I'd much rather use them all than not use them at all. Actually, no. I'd much rather not use them at all because there'd be no need to use them at all. But here we go. Paralyzed and Calm move. That is exactly what I wanted. Should I go for the Thunder? I'm pretty sure... Yeah. Let's go for the Thunder and hopefully it connects. It does not connect. Spark Plug, what are you doing? Didn't bring your glasses today, Spark Plug. You did not bring your glasses today. But please don't poison. I'm actually going to heal. You might be thinking, why am I going to heal? I can still have another one. But if we do get hit with that and we get poisoned, that is not going to be happy for Spark Plug or anyone watching. Because we'll get poisoned and then hit and then it'll be taken down. See, also, I was going to say, banking on a paralysis. Let's go for another Thunder. We're too deep in... What are you doing, Spark Plug? And Hypnosis. At least you missed the Hypnosis. I know... Okay, let's go for Thunder again. What are... Spark Plug, are you serious? Do we have to have another meeting with you? Just bring your glasses. I know you don't like them. I know you think you look nerdy in them. But you know what? You do not. You look actually extremely good. It brings out your eyes, Spark Plug. Glasses bring out your eyes. You should really wear them and actually hit the Thunder. Okay. We're going to go for another Thunder. We're too deep into it to go for Shockwaves, even though it'd be more safe. What are you... What are you doing? I guess this is for all the luck that we had against the Bruno. Let's go for Thunder. It finally hits. There we go. Gengar looked so scary in that coloration when it went all like reverse colored. But Gengar almost died. Did not die. I'm pretty... Ooh. Did I have a Citrus Berry or something like that? Citrus Berry. So that will take it out of healing range, which is actually extremely good. And if not, two Shockwaves will be able to take it out. We were out of Thunders, which is not a good thing. But we are not going to be... Ooh. I might actually use one on Spark Plug before Lance, because I'm saying we're not going to use them during our during the Lance battle. But what if our Pokemon die and we have to use it? Then it would be extremely useful. But here comes Haunter. Let's go for a Thunder Wave just to kind of secure our victory on this guy. Haunter, you were paralyzed. You know what'd be really good? Persian with Scrappy. I just realized Hypnosis hits. That's okay. Even though Hypnosis. We don't want it. It's okay, because we did get that paralysis, and we do have the power of Awakenings, which is extremely good. So, Spark Plug, getting that Awakening. Dream Eater. You know what? We're not affected. How about that, Haunter? We wake up. We have Insomnia. We do not have Insomnia's ability. We have Bolt Absorb, but you know what? Might as well have the same thing with Awakenings. What am I talking about? But hopefully it does more than half. It does more than half. Takes it out with a critical hit. I don't know if the crit mattered, but... Oh, Spark Plug. I don't know if you just redeemed yourself, but you did alright. Oh my, you're something special, child. I don't know if your voice changed, but oh well, Agatha. You win. I see what the old Duff sees in you now. I have nothing else to say. Run along now, child. Run. I'm running. Actually, I'm not allowed to run in here. It's not letting me run. But our Pokemon, we're going to go back and heal up our Pokemon. Let's go for the Ethers. Restores selected moves PP. That's what we want, because we only want it on Thunder. So let's go for Thunder, not Thunder Wave. That'd be extremely, a waste of it. So we have one Aether and one Max Aether. So I'm pretty sure we can move it around, but you know what? Doesn't even matter. We're going to be versing Lance next. All right? And if anyone knows Lance, Lance leads off with that Gyarados. And Gyarados, even though it is kind of scary, we're going to be leading off with Drake because it can't do anything super effective against us. And with the, Hydro Pumps or wherever it has, we can absorb it. You might be saying Spark Plug would be extremely good to have, but he has Dragonair, Dragonair, Aerodactyl, and Dragonite, and those Pokemon are extremely weak to Ice, Drake. Okay, so I hope you guys did enjoy this episode. If you did enjoy this episode, leave a like, favorite, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff really helps me out. Feel free to leave your predictions in the comment section below. Keep them coming. See if we were going to, what you think, are we going to win or are we going to lose, anything like that. Follow me on Twitter if you haven't, link will be in the description below. And yeah, don't have much else to say. This has been Arodiad. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.